We recently looked at the new discovery of filament structures that were located in our neighbourhood. We also saw that the nearest open star cluster to us revealed an important part of the filament structure of the galaxy spiral arms. Mainstream science agrees that much of the interstellar medium is not simply filled with empty space. Instead, they see that it is a hierarchical structure and facilitates the formation of filaments that are governed by the galactic potential on a large scale. We already know that there is a network of hydrogen filaments that is structured mostly parallel to the galactic plane. In 2010, astronomers discovered a highly filamented dark cloud, which they called Nessie. They believe that it is one of the first filaments whose morphology is likely governed by the structural dynamics of the galaxy. Because of this, they dubbed this type of filament the bones of the Milky Way, as they think that its formation, evolution, and shape could be closely linked to the global spiral arm structure. Within molecular clouds, they discovered giant molecular filaments. These seem to have the highest masses while exhibiting the lowest column densities and star-forming activity, making them good candidates to be intermediate descendants of the atomic interstellar medium structures. These structures are not only associated with spiral arms, but are also located in inter-arm regions. The recently discovered Radcliffe wave is yet another example of filaments in our local neighbourhood. Even in their own simulations, they found that giant molecular clouds often form as large filaments. Now, obviously, they see the formation process a little differently and quote things like, "In our simulations, the galactic shear between the spiral arms plays a critical role in the formation of highly filamented structures." Their assumption is also that these giant molecular clouds tend to sustain their large filamentary shape before entering the spiral arms, where they are prone to being disrupted by local events of star formation and stellar feedback. And yet, we have examples of large filaments that are located in our neighbourhood. Peering through our galaxy is not easy, and now astronomers think that they have spotted a massive filament of atomic hydrogen. This is one of the largest structures ever observed in our galaxy. It is located about 55,000 light years away on the other side of the Milky Way. The research is based on data obtained by THOR, an observational program that relies on the Very Large Array in New Mexico. The project studies molecular cloud formation, the conversion of atomic molecular hydrogen, the galaxy's magnetic field, and other questions related to interstellar medium and star formation. The ultimate purpose is to determine how the two most common types of hydrogen gas converge to create dense clouds that give rise to new stars. These two types are atomic hydrogen and molecular hydrogen. The process of how atomic hydrogen transitions to molecular hydrogen is still largely unknown, which is why finding this huge filament is so important. To put the size into context, the largest known clouds of molecular hydrogen are around 800 light years in length. This new cloud, which they called Maggie, measures just shy of 4,000 light years long and 130 light years wide. More interesting is that parts of this filament extend about 1,600 light years below the plane of the Milky Way. When they analysed the speed of the material moving in the filament, they determined that it had a mean velocity of 54 kilometers per second. They were also able to show that the velocities along the filament barely differ. They determined that this filament might be remotely linked to the global spiral arm structure of the Milky Way. They were not able to detect any carbon monoxide emissions or dust in the filament, and there were no signs of new stars forming along the filament. On closer inspection, the team noticed that the gas converges at various points along the filament, which led them to conclude that the hydrogen gas accumulates into large clouds at these locations. The Maggie filament discloses a hub-like feature in the east, on which small-scale filaments appear to converge, and a tail that thins out towards the west. The northwestern part shows a connection to the midplane, potentially feeding off hydrogen material located at higher latitudes. So many of you will not be surprised by these findings, but is there more that we can learn from these observations? An important point to note is that although these filaments are composed of atomic hydrogen, that doesn't mean that they are not a plasma. Even if only one atom in 10,000 is ionized, it can be considered a plasma. Therefore, the motion will be dominated electromagnetically. If we examine the overall structure of the filament and look at the centroid velocity, we can see that this speeds up and slows down. What might cause the velocity to speed up? Around these areas, we also see a much higher density of the cloud. This is likely an indication that electromagnetic pinching is occurring. This would tend to compress the material, increasing the density and also increasing the velocity. In larger, more dense filaments, these are probably the areas where most star formation is taking place. At these points, we would also expect Markland convection to be strongest, creating a greater spread of material around these points, which is what we see to some extent in the images of the filaments so far obtained. In Markland convection, hydrogen is the outermost ion from the center axis which becomes deionized or recombines with an electron. The diffuse nature of Maggie and the lack of a CO signal except on the smaller scale along the axis suggests that this is a juvenile filament. One important aspect is also that they see the movement of the material in the filament. This once more confirms the idea that it is the movement of this material in the filaments which powers the stars that reside in them.